end of something for you too. It's no big deal, just we have to go away and just dream it all up again.
We're not in Lovetown anymore. We're in Berlin, Germany. Destination, Zoo Station. In German, it's Bahnhof Zoo, the colloquial name for Bahnhof Zoologischer Garten.
This is Zoo Station. It really exists. That's not a figment of our imagination. And there is a U2 line that runs through it. There's also a real zoo.
A real place, sure. Though surely a metaphor. But for what? An illusion provides a clue.
In the garden in the cool of the day, Adam and his wife hid themselves in the presence of the Lord God. So the Lord God said to the serpent, "You will crawl on your belly and you will eat dust all the days of your life."
What's all this talk of being ready? Another clue? Several of Jesus' parables are about being ready.
You also must be ready. Come, for everything is now ready. The bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut.
Zoo Station. It's not just a place, but a person. You can almost miss this clue at the end. He's just down the line from your love, under the sign of your love. A destination, a definite hope, just two stops down the line. A person's love, and he's gonna make it on time. The real thing evokes many cultural illusions.
Come and see the real thing, come and see the real thing, come and see the real thing.
In the Gospels, Jesus is the true Messiah and the true light. The Message, published in 1993, cuts to the chase and calls him the real thing.
The lifelight blazed out of the darkness. The lifelight was the real thing.
When Jesus was arrested, Peter denied knowing him. Not once, not twice, but three times.
Give me one more chance. Give me two more chances. You won't be denied. One more chance. Let me be a lover tonight.
But isn't it about other things we use to take us higher? Sex, drugs, and rock and roll? A biblical allusion opens other doors. On the eve of his death, Jesus promised the Holy Spirit in his place. He explained it would be even better than him.
Rock and roll band needs a drug of choice. Alcohol, sometimes chemicals, has been the Holy Spirit. I hope so. But tonight, it's you.
But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you.
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll, sure. But don't forget the Holy Spirit, the best substitute, according to Jesus and Bono, for the real thing.
The father and son story. It's a religious father and son. I have a lot of seen fun, loving family situations which just are completely anti-Christian.
Bono conceived one as an argument between a religious father and gay son, hence the heavy biblical allusions.
You say, one love, one life.
Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh.
Paul said that we are one, but not the same.
For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office, so we, being many, are one body in Christ.
Jesus raised the dead and healed the lepers. He claimed authority to forgive sin and was accused of playing God.
Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Son, your sins are forgiven.
To the lepers in your head.
Paul asked his brothers and sisters to carry each other's burdens.
Sisters, brothers, carry each other, carry each other.
Oh. Brothers and sisters, carry each other's burdens, and in this way you will fulfill the law of Christ.
Jesus condemned religious leaders who do not enter, nor let those enter who are trying to.
Ask me to enter, well then you make me crawl.
In live performances, there's another allusion. Jesus said, "Ask and it will be given to you. Knock and the door will be opened." Will the religious father let the son enter? Or will he make him crawl? The Last Supper occurred in the large upper room in the evening. It was a low-lit room. They were close together. So close that one disciple was leaning on Jesus' bosom.
Last time we met was a low-lit room. We was close together, so bride and groom.
They ate the food and drank the wine till Jesus became troubled. He announced that one of them would betray him and started talking about strange things like the end of the world.
We ate the food, we drank the wine. Everybody having a good time, except you.
Judas took the money as payment for his betrayal. He spiked Jesus' drink, in a sense, for it was soon a cup of suffering.
I took the money, I spiked your drink. You miss too much these days if you stop to think.
The official breakup occurred in the garden. When Judas kissed him, Jesus said, "Do what you came for, friend." Moments before this, Jesus had been overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death.
In the garden, I was playing the tar. I kissed your lips and broke your heart.
When Judas saw what he had done, he deeply regretted it. He tried to return the money and repent, but nothing worked. He hanged himself in a field, his insides spilling out.
Surround me, going down on me, spilling over the brim.
Perhaps Judas reached out to Jesus, to the one he tried to destroy. Could Jesus, the jilted lover, ever forgive his betrayer? Judas would have to wait until the end of the world.
I reached out for the one I tried to destroy. You, you said you'd wait.
The cello and wind sets the scene. It's hollow, empty, haunted.
Well, you left my heart empty as a vacant lot. For any spirit to haunt.
In one of Jesus' parables, an impure spirit leaves a man's house. He keeps it empty, and the spirit returns with many others to haunt him.
When an impure spirit comes out of a person, it goes through arid places seeking rest. Then it says, "I will return to the house I left." It finds the house unoccupied, swept clean. Then it goes and takes with it seven other spirits, and they go in and live there.
To fall at the feet of someone is an act of worship. Many fell at Jesus' feet. To fall at the foot of a lover may appear sweet, but biblically it's a red flag.
You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not bow down to them or worship them.
In Revelation, the one who is holy and true opens doors that no one can close.
See, I have placed before you an open door that no one can shut. I will make them come and fall down at your feet and acknowledge that I have loved you.
Will she remain wild, without rest? Or will she return to his empty house? It's bitter. He's only hanging on to watch her go down. A cruel death wish. In the Song of Solomon, jealousy is cruel as the grave.
You're so cruel.
Set me as a seal upon thine heart, for love is strong as death. Jealousy is cruel as the grave.
Her spirit is in the air, which is how Paul describes the devil.
They look for you, but your spirit is in the air.
As for you, you were dead in your transgressions and sins when you followed the ruler of the kingdom of the air, the spirit at work in those who are disobedient.
Paradoxically, she is also heavenly. Her skin is pale like God's only dove, an allusion to the baptism of Jesus.
Her skin is pale like God's only dove.
At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him.
He has a head of heaven, but fingers are in the mire, the miry clay of Psalm 40.
Heaven, heaven, fingers in the mire.
I waited patiently for the Lord. He lifted me out of the pits, out of the mud and mire.
As Micah says, she will be trampled underfoot like mire in the streets. He will gladly watch her go down.
My eyes will see her downfall. Even now, she will be trampled underfoot like mire in the streets.
For jealousy is cruel as the grave. So cruel.
You're so cruel.
The first allusion is easy to miss. In the Bible, the prince of devils is called Beelzebub. The translation of the Hebrew Beelzebub is Lord of the Flies. In 1981, NME prints Bono's reading matter, The Bible, and Lord of the Flies. Stars falling from the sky signifies Judgment Day, the end of the world.
The sun will be darkened, the stars will fall from the sky, and the heavenly bodies will be shaken.
It's not just stars falling. We also are falling from the sky, like Lucifer, who fell from heaven.
I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. The sun turned black, the whole moon turned blood red, and the stars in the sky fell to earth.
One man's lie alludes to Adam or Jesus. Adam, who disobeyed God in the garden, a man will fall. Jesus, called a liar by some, a false messiah, a man will rise. In pride, one man come he to justify, but not here.
The universe exploded,
just as sin entered the world through one man, how much more through the one man, Jesus Christ.
Jesus claimed knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven. But in the flies' world, such truth claims are meaningless. They are no secret at all. There's a saying, God moves in mysterious ways, which stems from an 18th century hymn.
God.
Which in turn stems from Ecclesiastes.
As you do not know the path of the wind, or how the body is formed in a mother's womb, so you cannot understand the work of God.
God's mysteriousness is also a theme in Oscar Wilde's play Salome. In Salome, John the Baptist is living underground in King Herod's prison, fearful of women. The album was almost called Fear of Women, but Bono takes a different turn. He says, I've always believed that the spirit is a feminine thing. The spirit in Hebrew is feminine. In Genesis, she hovers and flutters over the waters.
Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters.
She moves in mysterious ways.
In the end, it's not fear of women. It's fear of the feminine spirit. But it's all right. She'll be there to lift you up and comfort you like a mother or a lover and teach you all things.
I feel your comfort, love. I need your comfort. Mother Spirit, teach me.
I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. But the Comforter, whom the Father will send in my name, shall teach you all things.
In 2005, Bono said, "Be silent and know that I am God." That's a favorite line from the scriptures. However, in most translations, it's "Be still and know that I am God."
He says, "Be still and know that I am God."
The man instead is trying to throw his arms around the world, to grasp it, embrace it, save it. Is this Bono's hangover from the 80s? The Bible warns against wanting glory in the world, a slight conundrum for a rock star.
What good will it be for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit their soul?
The prodigal son almost wasted away in reckless living, but he made his way back home.
Came to his senses, he said, "I will set out and go back to my father." But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him, and kissed him.
In a dream, he sees Salvador Dali taking an open-top beetle through the eye of a needle.
An open-top beetle through the eye of a needle. I was trying to throw my arms.
It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God.
The problem persists. Will he ever heed the call, be still, and stop trying to be like God?
Be still,
be still and know that I am God.
Woman,
ultraviolet means light beyond the perception of the eye. In the Bible, God is called light, yet paradoxically is difficult to perceive.
God is light. No one has ever seen God. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him.
Jesus said to store your treasure in heaven, for there it can't be found.
You bury your treasure where it can't be found.
Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where thieves do not break in and steal.
When Jacob saw a stairway to heaven, he was asleep on a stone.
Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep. Yet a dream, in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, reaching to heaven.
In the Psalms, God can light one's way. His word is a lamp in the darkness.
You, Lord, keep my lamp burning. My God, turns my darkness into light. Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path.
But it's not God light my way, it's baby light my way. Is this even about God? Bono leaves it up to you, but the title won't leave you alone. A constant reminder, it's not regular light, but something other.
You are the light of the world. Let your light shine before others.
A major theme in Acrobat is the struggle to believe in God.
Don't believe what you hear. Don't believe what you see. You just close your eyes. You can feel the enemy!
Though hearing, they do not hear. Though seeing, they do not see. The evil one comes and snatches away what was sown in their heart.
This is the parable of the sower, where Jesus said the thorns can choke you. It's one of the only two places choke is used in the entire Bible.
Listen to what the parable of the sower means. Like seed sown among thorns, the worries of this life come in and choke the word.
Bono cites the Lord's Supper, yet appears anti-church, empathetic with a non-believer with a God-shaped hole.
Jesus took bread. He broke it, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body." Then he took a cup, saying, "Drink from it, all of you."
Bono's advice? Dream out loud. Sing a new song in defiance of Ecclesiastes.
What has been will be again. What has been done will be done again. There is nothing new under the sun.
Bono ends with a big idea. When you have nothing left, when the bastards, the enemies, grind you down, that's when you can love. Love is your way out, your lifeline, the one thing that you can believe in.
If I do not have love, I am nothing. Love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you.
In the Bible, love is not blindness. God is love, and Jesus made the blind to see. Bono's wires are crossed. There's a disconnect, a crisis of faith.
Let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth knoweth God, for God is love.
What appears to be at odds with the Bible is not. In Psalm 139, the psalmist tries to flee from God, saying, "Won't you wrap the night around
me?" I will say, "Let the darkness cover me, and the night wrap itself around me."
But the psalmist cannot escape God, because even the night is like light to God. Bono instead offers no such hope. Why? Why does Achtung Baby end in darkness? Is it disbelief in love? In God? Perhaps? Or something else? But what?
Music that really turns me on is either music running toward God or away from God. But both recognize the pivot. Whether you're running away or whether you're running toward, God is at the center.